Howdy, folks, and welcome back to Ark Adventures. I'm a little busy right now. I'm sorry I'm looking down because I'm paying close attention to this. A terror bird egg. And the reason I'm paying close attention to that is that, obviously, I bred two terror birds. Now, you recall that last episode I tamed a female terror bird that was much lower level than 65. I went out and found another one, a slightly higher level, and I thought I'd breed them and see what I can get as a result. Acme, the lower level female, has been renamed to Rhodey. And now I have Mrs. Roadrunner, and we're going to hatch this egg, and we're going to see what we get. So I'll be back in a bit. All right, the egg is just about to hatch, and I like the pink color of these. And I haven't seen a terror bird lay an egg, and the wiki doesn't indicate that they actually have eggs. But, I mean, I'm looking at one of their eggs right now from breeding them. So they must actually lay them, or if they don't already, they're going to pretty soon. So I wonder what their kibble will be for. Maybe they won't activate their eggs until they come up with something for it to actually work for kibble on. And baby should be coming any second. Level 97, not bad. Not bad. I'm not going to give it a name at the moment. I'm going to go ahead and feed it a little bit of meat, though. Pretty sure these things, I mean, I tame them with meat. They eat meat, so yeah. I think he's eating, I hope. Is he eating? Is that meat going to go away? Please tell me they eat meat. They eat meat when they're an adult. Oh, there we go, yeah. Woo! Excellent. So I imagine at some point they're going to start laying eggs. So not bad. Level 97, I like. Male, unfortunately. I would have liked another female for the eggs, but hey. Can't be too picky now, can we? Let's go ahead and set this guy to disable wandering. He's already following me. Let's get him to come out here past London. London's holding all my meat for me. Just took London out. Killed a couple things real quick just to grab a whole bunch of meat. London's really good for that. Come on, buddy. You can do it. Come on. Come on out here. Let's have everybody take a look at you. Oh, my goodness. Very tiny. Oh, that's awesome. All right, well, I'm going to continue giving this guy some meat, but I also want to deal today with electricity. Now, I talked before about how we have these electrical wires running out here to Rook's place and how I don't really like them, but I have a dilemma now. I have moved so much of my work area out there where you see dump truck now parked. Dump truck's great for just going and quickly getting a whole bunch of berries. I like that, so I'm kind of leaving dump truck there as I do things. I'm thinking about putting some refrigerators out there as well, so we can hold, since we have the industrial cooker out there, we can hold the kibble and the eggs and that sort of thing out there instead of in here. But that's kind of difficult if we use the same generator. So I have this dilemma. Either I'm going to have wires, high-rise wires, because one of the options, let me feed him a little bit more, if I can find him, there he is, and then show you guys what I'm talking about. You're not still following me. Oh, you are. Stop following me. Thank you. One of the things I can do, of course, I can run it out along the ground, but it would look really ugly. So if I was going to run wires out from that one generator, I would probably, let me not stick to the birds, probably find a location out there, like right out here, and throw in a T-section and run a line straight across until I got close to this work area. Should pop up here. There we go. And then drop it down and feed the power right here. That's one way to do it, and I can have some refrigerators along here. Another option, though, I don't know. I don't really like all the wires up in the air. It's really tacky. I was talking about maybe putting a generator over there at Rook's place for her when she finalized her place so I could put a generator for her. And then I'm thinking, well, why wouldn't I put a generator over here as well? If I put a generator over here, that means I'm going to have three generators. Well, two to start with, but eventually three generators that I need to keep filled with gas. And that seems kind of wasteful. So I'm not really quite sure what I want to do here. Anyway, let me get this bird up to the point where it's a juvenile and can feed from the trough. And then we'll revisit this particular question. Okay, the new terror bird's just about right. In fact, just went. The trough icon just appeared. So he will eat from the trough. I'll go ahead and take the rest of the meat off him and throw it in the trough. And I want to talk about those electricity options now. And I'm thinking Let me also throw his saddle on him. I'm thinking we're going to not do the wires. I really wish... I can't put the saddle in there. Oh, doesn't have enough weight for it. I don't think we're doing the wires. And the reason being, there's just no way to disguise them. I mean, I kind of wish there was some kind of structure you could put in the air that wasn't supported, or that you could support every once in a while. Kind of like a telephone pole, you know? Or something that could disguise those wires. Or even a really expensive wireless electricity transmitter, you know, where you have to put one on each side and connect a generator up to some cabling or something on the other side. That would be awesome, but there is no such thing. So I think we're going to dismantle all of that wiring. We're going to turn off Rook's fridge, take all of the meat that's still in there if there is any, and she has a light there too, but we're just going to basically take her power away from her for now until she's finalized her place. Her home here, and then we'll help her get a generator going. So I think I'm going to put a generator in. These guys have enough food, right? Yeah. I think I'm going to put a generator in or on the work area, on the shop, if you will, workshop, and do that. So I'm going to start dismantling all of this wiring, and I think, let me see if the magic still holds. Can you make magically floating wiring? You can. I guess it's not really floating. I guess it would be floating if I did this, right? Yeah, magic floating wiring. it's still a thing. So I'm going to go ahead and dismantle all this wiring, get back a lot of this metal. I have to watch my weight here. And then I'll be back as we set up a generator for the new joint. All right, folks, I've come to a bigger decision. Not only have I decided I'm going to put an electrical generator out here, but I've also decided that I like change. I embrace change. I love change. In fact, I love change so much that I really, my favorite part of playing any game like Ark or Minecraft or anything else, survival type games or building type games, is starting over. I don't want to start over. Don't worry. But what I am going to do is I'm going to make this, instead of just being a workshop, I'm going to expand this. And I'm going to make this my whole new base. I'm going to wall it in. I'm going to roof it. I'm going to make an aerial landing place for the birds. I'm going to have a way for storage, you know, a storage area probably along here as well, and have a channel that I can ride, you know, bring my dinos through, my quetzes and that sort of thing. And at the same time, I think I'm actually going to demolish a lot of this original base. First of all, that bridge, when I first built it, it kind of made sense because I didn't really have a lot of quetz capability. So using my dinos to collect resources and then coming down the elevator just kind of made sense. I don't use it. I never use it. I think I'm going to demolish it. Now I'm going to take the tower down because I'm getting rid of that generator anyway that's in the tower. And that was really one of the main reasons I built the tower was partially for the bridge, but also to hide the generator up there so I didn't have to hear it when it was running. So I think I'm going to demolish all of that. I think I'll leave this house over here, the small dino house. Because what I'm going to do when I reclaim all this area is I'm going to turn it all into dino storage. So all my dinos can have a much more roomier area to move around in. The Brontos can move around a lot better and so forth. And then I'll just have the big behemoth gates up here and then my main house right in between. My main structure. And I might move the artifact pedestals at some point and put them in a nicer place as well. So what I'm going to do first, and I probably won't, I know I'm not going to get all of this done in this episode. Probably not in the next several episodes, but it'll be a fun thing to do over the next several episodes. First thing I'm going to do, though, is expand the foundations. I'm going to come out just a little bit so that there's no water showing here on here and come out in front of this greenhouse as well. I'm going to expand out to the right a bit, expand out to the left a bit with foundations. I can't go forward anymore. This is like the farthest forward I can go, as you see, pretty much this foundation, maybe even the one behind that. I think that one sticking out is really for these guys for feeding. In fact, I think I'm going to leave this back here as a back porch, this one foundation depth, and I think the walls will be along here, right? The back door, basically. And this will just be kind of a docking area for the water dinos, which works just fine right now. You can see how it will work. It's pretty cool. But I'll go out a little wider, I think, this direction as well. And I think it'll be pretty cool. And I've got a Bronto sticking its tail through my gate, which happens all the time. And another Bronto up there. Anyway, So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to expand the foundations, and then I'm going to put the generator in place and start putting in some refrigerators. I've already manufactured a couple of refrigerators over here. I got the resources for them. Two refrigerators, a light. So I was getting ready for the generator house. So let me go do that. Let me gather all the resources I'm going to need, build all the foundations so I can expand this a ways, start getting some walls ready to go. I think the front part of this base up to about here is going to be exposed too. So I think you'll have the greenhouse sitting out there in the open, and probably this area will be kind of a driveway, maybe, if you want to think of it that way. Or maybe not. We'll see how it works out. Anyway, let me get busy. Okay, since we know we're going to demolish this bridge, I think the first thing we should do is begin the demolishing process. And I think what I'm going to do is let you guys watch all that in a time-lapsed, not really a montage, but a time-lapse. So let's get these birds out of here, and here we go. Okay, we're back, and we've demolished a lot of our old base. You can see the actual storage cabinet for the gasoline right up there, the generator. I built tore the tower down to the generator level and left it because I'm going to need the generator running for a while. Left most of the house intact, took away this foundation, obviously took away the entire bridge, put spike walls up. You may have seen that in the montage. I don't know, the speedy up part. Put spike walls up to cover the gap where the bridge used to be. I took away most of this foundation. I was hesitant to take away these last two here because I don't know if they... It looks like they go underneath these vaults a little bit, and I didn't want to demolish the vaults, not waste the resources, especially. In fact, I lost some resources because I accidentally demolished an elevator actual rail that was too close. It was actually the elevator platform itself was touching it, and it demolished the elevator platform, and I didn't get any of the resources from it. So that kind of sucked. So I went ahead and demolished over here this entire foundation. The dino gateway that was here just went away when I demolished one of the foundations. My mistake. I should have done that and salvaged some of those resources too. I really wanted to get each individual thing demolished so I could get all the resources back. I'm going to leave this ramp here with AC-130 at least up there for now, and the small dino house for sure. And I'll leave all of this stuff here for now until I move everything to the new place. And speaking of the new place, here it is. It's going to be, I went wide this way, and I went wide that way. Let me talk about this way first. I'm going to leave this open to the air. I'm going to build out these columns, and I think what I'm going to do is instead of the tops being uneven like this, because I was building from the ground up, I think I'm going to take one of these as the guideline, guidepost, if you will, and lay a ceiling on it, and use ceilings to guide my other pillars so that they all line up at the top. I think that would be kind of cool. And look at that Anki swimming out here. What are you doing? Now that I have land over here, now that there's foundations, they see it as someplace they can go to, and they come over here, which is kind of irritating. Anyway, I'm going to build these pillars out for that reason, so these guys won't go through all the way out to the end down here, until just shy of this ramp, and this is the only ramp I'm going to have on this side, and then I'm going to have these ramps down here to get to the water creatures, and I'm going to be putting a wall. Actually, I'm not going to put any walls down here. The walls are going to be over on this side. So like I said, this is going to be open to the air because I'm going to have... Past here, I'm going to have a ton of... You really need to leave my house. Go away. Go away. I'm going to have not a ton, but I'm going to have several vaults aligned along here. And this will be kind of an offloading area for the bigger dinos and things of that nature. And then there's going to be a work area back behind there. And I'll have this one vault here. It's kind of my work vault. It'll have the things I'm currently working on, the resources I'm working on, things I need. It'll have more middle. We'll be here, cementing paste if I make extras, and that sort of thing will be there. So that's what this site is for. And, of course, the greenhouse is going to stay here. It's going to be open air. In fact, the walls are going to start kind of right. In fact, I made some of these to kind of illustrate. Kind of there, right? And here, and there'll probably be a doorway here to connect to this doorway. But the walls are going to come out along here. And I'm thinking that this will be open air. I see the egg. I'll get it. This is going to be open air, kind of like that greenhouse is. I might enclose it, though. I might kind of turn it into a hangar of sorts and drive my quetzes in here, have them under the ground, and then up above, have ramps going up to up above, and that's where I'll put the RGs and the pteranodons and that sort of thing. Back here, once I've destroyed all the houses, this is all going to be for the animals. And I'll try to do a better job of organizing them and putting them in better places. And I'm going to have to put in some kind of foundations, pillars, or something. To keep the wild spawns from happening in here. Because they will spawn. Even if I have wild dinos in there, if there's no foundations, they will spawn. So I need to do something about that. So I've built as far as I can with foundations, with the resources I recovered from the demolishing efforts. I'm going to have to demolish more and gather more resources to finish out this section and that section right over there. And then I'm going to start putting the walls up and turn this into a real base. So I think that'll be kind of fun. Out here, I'm pretty sure if this is going to be an open-air hangar, you know, it's hard to describe, but actually kind of want to put a porch around everything if I can, but I don't think I can. I don't think it's wide enough. Let's see. What's that look like? That's two foundations. Yeah, that's enough for me to deal with for running around here. So basically everything to this side is going to be work area. Me, basically. And small dinos, maybe. Really small dinos. But then everything over here is going to be like Quetz parking and bird parking up top and maybe other animal parking, I think. And if that's the case, I think I can do like this. Like everything in here is for Quetz. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is it 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. No, it's 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 foundations wide. And I think Quetzes can fit in there fairly easily. One single file. You probably can't double them up very well, although you could probably squeeze 2 in there. And then build this up. See if I can kind of describe what I'm talking about. So like 4? Is 4 high enough for a Quetz? Maybe 5. 5 high, and then a roof across, a ceiling across, and the roof will come all the way across, all the way over to this side too. And we'll end... Actually, it'll probably continue going across, all the way to this side. I imagine, because if it's that high, I can drive everything in here. Brontos, everything can come in here, no problem. So, I think that's what I'm thinking of. And then on the roof, of course, I'll have some kind of ramp system to get me up there, because you know I hate ladders. So there'll be a ramp, probably starting at the back, maybe at the front as well, maybe right back here, as well as on the other side. That'll get me up to the top, so I can get to the other birds, the other flyers. But that's what I'm thinking of, guys. I don't know. I think it'll work. Well, it'll be interesting. Let's put it that way. I don't know where I'm going to put the generator yet. It'll be out here somewhere in my work area. But I'll try to find some nice, even place. And this whole thing is going to be kind of flat in one story, so it doesn't really matter. I mean, the foundation's going to be flat in one story. My work area is going to be flat in one story, so it doesn't really matter. Although I might just put it... No, I was going to say I might just put it up top there so I don't hear it. But then I have to worry about dropping cables and running cables. I don't want to deal with that. I just want to deal with everything flat for electricity. So we'll probably put it out here somewhere. And then again, these pedestals, these pillars with the artifacts, they're going to go. They're going to be moved. I am going to keep them. I really like what they look like at night. It's just awesome. I've got a few videos where I've showed it at night, and it's just so cool how it glows, all the different colors. I'll find some place to put that. In fact, they might actually be... Oh, now that I think about it, those are what I might scatter back here at various points as the foundation to try to keep wild dinos from not spawning, is these 6 artifacts. I might just kind of arrange them, maybe 3 and then 3. You know, 3 over here and 3 over here going back, and put the artifacts on them. So that might be pretty cool, actually. It'll give me a little bit of light back there. It kind of glows a little bit. That's kind of cool. All right. Well, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and stay tuned. We're going to do a lot more construction and building of this new revised Southern Island base in the coming episodes. I appreciate you watching. Hope you had fun. I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.